first bar, second bar, and third bar. Put our palms together. Pass on the Dharma lineage to sincere piety. Unwavering, promote the Suci spirit. Cherish Suci affinities. Innumerable meanings of sincere Dharma lineage. Good morning to Master Chen Yan and all the abroad masters. Go, 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 go. Forward, forward, forward. Do study and listen to the Dharma. Study and listen to the Dharma. We are more diligent and draw closer to Master's heart. Please be seated for those who are drawing closer to Master's heart. This online study opens up to all hearts. And let us all together read Master's footprints and united by Suci affinities. And for all, wherever you are online now, pass on the Dharma mindfully and pass on the great Dharma teachings. Let us spread the Dharma teachings online. Together, we can pass on the Dharma teachings. How are everybody here today? We all have our own opportunities and potential. In addition to our all the online, so we have more than 9,000 people online now.
Sister Epi has started translating.
Yes. Master encouraged us to pass on the Dharma teachings and appreciate all the talents that we have online. Again and again, we are searching for Master's talents, talented disciples, and to pass on the Dharma lineage and great love to all. Have an open mind, be diligent and not arrogant. Have a good virtues and merits. If there are people with such talents, can be masters, talents, disciples. Wish everyone have a everyone can become an ideal talent in master's eyes. Master, please be at ease, be relieved. I'm your ideal disciple. Masters have now give a thumbs up in response. Thank you for accompanying me in this online book study. Let us give ourselves an applause for joining this online group study. For those who are online and at home, please on your phone and give us some positive feedbacks and come and join our this book study group to see the beauty that comes from all the hard work and diligence. And glory does not come from waiting. Please provide us some positive feedback. And this today's book study is very amazing, with very enriching products, enriching sessions and sharing. And to pass on the Jingshi Dharma lineage and to motivate through Suci School of Buddhism. Let us follow this direction, Suci spirits and values. Believe in ourselves, have unwavering heart in our resolve and listen to the Dharma teachings. Believe that we all have the potential and let us determine maintain our initial aspiration. Since we want to be loved, Master, we should provide and encourage and spread the Buddha's teaching, working hard along with Suci's mission, again and again, again and again, and those online, please join together. If we love Suci, speak more about Suji, spread Suji values, always speak Suji to everyone that we meet, and have Dharma in our heart, always speak, have good speech and good actions. Only goodness can spread and flourish in this world. We hope together we can spread the Dharma teachings together. Go, go, go. Moving forward, moving forward, moving forward. Today we are on January 20th. It's our fourth session of this online MOOC study, and have the third group from Singapore, Malaysia team of translator. Let us give them the applause. Brother Andrew, Sister Shichun, Sister Lily, Brother Eugene Tang, and Effie, myself. Okay. We welcome feedbacks from everyone. Master always says that team effort is very important and have to work unitedly and in harmony to spread the Dharma teachings. Online, to spread the Dharma teachings far and wide. Let us know where you are now and give us some positive feedbacks to energize this session. Let us give applause to all on board and everyone around the world. This is an important part that we are going to discuss. We have brothers and sisters from mainland China who always provide positive feedbacks and always give us a lot of energies that appreciate this Kaohsiung online group study, and very happy to listen to all the positive feedbacks that can provide energies to instill and inculcate good reading habits among all. This is the feedback from our brother and sister from US. Now we're going to have a sharing session. Let us encourage all to carry on this big ox cart, spreading the Dharma teachings through all various methods and also online. We are grateful for the advancement in technology that can enable this online book studies to encourage to spread far and wide to benefit so many people online. From this feedback from Hebei, she likes to sing, and she always likes to have Brother David use a session sharing. She enjoyed the sharing very much. There's another feedback from P that we are very happy to know that some schools are being in the plan in the Middle East. There's no differences in Dharma, whether higher level or lower level. The most important thing is to listen and absorb and contemplate the Dharma. That's another. Emily is from England. She has provided some feedbacks that though the time is short, she have known more and more and have gained more knowledge through this five sessions sharing. She, even though the sharing sometimes are short, only 5 minutes, yet she is very grateful to have received positive energies and thoughts in her. She appreciates very much. Let us continue to spread all the Dharma. And we are happy for all who have contributed. And I'm grateful to all the sharers who have provided so many positive feedbacks for us from various countries like Taiwan and Thailand. Now let us follow the field of blessings. Let us also at the same time be cautious with our health and by having good hygiene habits. There are some feedbacks from Singapore for their feedbacks. And the CEO of Singapore, Shichi, is also present here online. We also have families from Canada, the online, Jennifer and the team, and the rest are also online to support our book study today. There are many good wishes from Vancouver, Canada, and some of the team members are back to Taiwan now and being quarantined now. We are very grateful to our family from US. Let us give our happy blessings and utmost gratitude to the brothers and sisters here who have been connected online with us in their sharing. Let us now also welcome our senior and elders who are here to support us. Our group, our family members from Beijing also are very diligently in following this online book study. Let us give them some applause to the people from Beijing, our family members in Beijing that have been a follower and have been supporting all this while. All our friends from abroad have also followed through with us this online study group. Give us the warmth and support and encouragement. No matter where you are, in US, in UK, we go beyond borders, space and time with this advancement in technology that provided this platform for us to connect with each other. Sister Ai Chu from US. Sister Ai Chu is giving her feedbacks. She said her sharings, the sharings that she has listened with wisdom, and she cherished very much. And in Singapore, there are many vegetarian restaurants are coming up. The feedback from Effie that the book shared by sister last week was still not in the bookshelf in KL, Malaysia. Wherever we are, we see the place is a beautiful place and full of good and beautiful people. Let us have encouraged and motivate more and more people to draw closer to Master's heart through all the Dharma teachings that we are spreading through online, through this platform, this book study. During this of the Dharma decade, we should encourage and push forward more efforts to encourage and make sure that the Dharma can reach out to more and more people so that people can turn to more positiveness. This is engagement from our sister Liu from her sharing last week. Our brother and sisters from USA also have provided us some positive feedback. And they are full of grace now. Now, one of the brothers, she's joining us while having her lunch now. Let us give our support and applause to this sister who's joining us online, though she's having her meal round. A sister here who has given us a very poematic message and feedback. It's very encouraging and support. Hoping she's on line with us today. You do not need to be intelligent or knowledgeable. The most important is to start the first step to join us. To nurture gradually to gain more in-depth and wisdom. Let us now call out to our U.S., our United Nations. Let us call out to our United Nations. Let us keep close to our Thai TV to get more news about the international affairs. There are many, many places with great love. Though we don't have many city people in every corner of the earth, but we still can spread the great love and leave a footprint in all these places. Through Thai TV, we can gain knowledge where we are. We still can overcome situations like the Ebola virus and the pandemic now. Through Thai TV, we can get connected with the world affairs and through the United Nations platform and with the participation of Suchi. This is our cooperation with United Nations and where we send our great love and relief efforts being carried out worldwide through this cooperation. And they feel that our foundation is one of the most recognized international organization where we, in Suji, has spread the great love. No doubt, we are in such a pandemic situation. We still can receive good and positive encouragement and love back to Taiwan. We are most grateful to Sister Cihui for providing us all these video clips happening worldwide and through all these reports and knowledge from our United Nations representative and team. We can know what is happening in the world through their hard effort. We have CEOs, our own city CEOs, also being involved in this United Nations platform, and they always report back to Master Chen Yuan about the situation happening worldwide now. Now we were listening to Sister Zeng Zhihui and team for her sharing with us afterwards. We'd like to be with all of us because all of us have positive energies and talent. Now we will listen to Sister Zeng Zhihui. Good day to all, to Sister Teacher Megan, and all are staying online now. Do you see the clips that I'm providing now? Thank you for everyone who are online, and thank you to Sister Megan. It's not easy for the team to organize this platform. I'm very grateful to have this opportunity to share with all of you, and without the support from online participation from everyone, I won't be able to share. So with the blessing from Masters, United Nations, I'm very grateful for our predecessors who have paved the path for us. We are grateful to a number of our brothers and many great bodhisattvas who have spread the seeds of kindness and goodness so far and wide in the United Nations platform that can enable us to walk more smoothly and steadfastly, because they have paved the path so smooth. Now the only thing we have to move forward. We hope that everyone can accompany us in walking this path fearlessly and steadfastly. And we have Brother Chin from Chicago. We have representative from US, Thailand, Taiwan, Germany, and Malaysia. And we have a group of translators, and also from Malaysia. We are grateful for all the team members that formed the team at the United Nations. Yes. In year 2003, we have walked through 18 years. We are grateful for Master's Chen Yuan's blessing that enabled us to be in the United Nations speech and recognition for the past 18 years. Master always says that we must always believe. That everyone has put in their effort to enable this to happen for the past 18 years, that having Shijing being recognized internationally. Shijing have already spread its Dharma lineage and also the Shijing School of Buddhism. Uh, Recently, Master has a reminder about the small star, little star in the galaxy. Now we have to uphold and shoulder the responsibilities of more diligently in speaking Shiqi and practicing the Master Dharma's teaching, more consulted in effort. We have 66 countries. Now must our city have stepped in to help in 119 countries. During this pandemic, we are in 66. We have 66 chapters worldwide. Is a star. The most important is the Shiqi's spirits and values, and Jinzi Dharma lineage is very important for us to promote this spirit worldwide. Master Chen Yuan has we have the latest version of Master Chen Yuan's books of the 21st century, the new version of the Three Realms books about the burning house, and these books are telling us about that we should immerse in the Dharma, listen to the Dharma, speak and share the Dharma, and practice and apply the Dharma to enable us to overcome all challenges, and also to relieve the sufferings wherever they are. In Malaysia, Master has said that whilst there are Chuchi volunteers who are, have worked diligently and are hired, there's still another, there will be another shoot and transition for the second batch to continue the good works of the city. How to seize the moment, the right moment to continue to spread this great love across. So in the 21st century, Master encouraged us and advised us that it's very important to use the technology to promote the spirit and the practice of Shiqi school of Buddhism and Jinzi Dharma lineage is being pushed forward up into international stage and focus. Master says that we should let more and more people to be aware and know and learn and listen to the right Dharma. Master says that Shiqi school of Buddhism and Jinzi Dharma lineage goes beyond borders and religions. Especially in times of this pandemic and gender equality conflicts, and so many difficulties, religion conflicts, wars, oil crisis and deforestation happening around, the more Master says that we should encourage the spirits and the values of Shiqi to flourish and be in the hearts of and connect more people to the Master, to our Shiqi spirits and its principles, to make it more sustainable. And make sure that the world is not drought, not dry, not hydrated with Dharma, but must always be immersed in the Dharma water. So that whenever the world faces a crisis or problems, so like Master says that for deforestation and about trash, which use clapping hands to do recycling for environmental protection. And for water conservation, we should be priority starting at source. And for the food crisis, we should promote an 80% food serving for self, and the balance 20% is to save up to help others. Master always says that no matter what religion we are, it's just in a name. All of us should adopt vegetarian as the latest release from the United Nations FAO, that every second, 2,556 animals are killed. So every day, 200 million animals are slaughtered, and every billion, 300 billion animals are killed. So as we are very grateful to our team from Philippines and India. We also are very grateful to our team shirt masters. And we are very touched with our volunteers from Mozambique that have turned a drought place that can now become a farm, so healthy, planted with greens and vegetables. We are so grateful for all these changes. As Master says that you should open the path and pave the road. Sun Shuji is now at its 55th year in 2021, and with its directions set for year 2021, Master says that we should take the Dharma lineage into the international stage and make sure that our United Nations representative can continue to work together with other religious groups internationally. We thank you. We are thankful for Sister Cihui for sharing with us the present situation in the United Nations, where Shuji is holding footprints have crossed over to 119 countries, set footprints in 119 countries. We are grateful to the diligent and hard work done by our team representative and its team representative from the United Nations. Due to time constraint, we are thankful, we are paused. Thank you. Now there's some further feedbacks. I shall pass the mic to Sister Sui San.
Thank you, Sister Effie. These are feedbacks from the viewers. Very grateful to Sister Mei Yun for her leadership in an online study group. Very grateful, very grateful. And also, also thanks to sisters from Thailand for their contribution to their society. She wrote to us that a lot of things that need to be done in Thailand. She will try her best what they can to help the society. Blessings to all the volunteers in Thailand. Thank you to Ming Chiu. All the positive comments from various viewers or whole world from around the world to the to Sister Mei Yun and the at Kaohsiung study group. Akong Ama, grandmother, grandfather, can you raise your hands and wave to our viewers online? Very grateful to everyone. The next one is on the master's journey. This is your turn for the master journey. Let us listen to Sister Yiling. Pastor and brothers and sisters, good morning. Today I'm sharing on the summer edition from May 9 to 15 May. This is related to a Buddha bathing ceremony. Let me introduce the meaning of three ceremonies in one. And Buddha itself is very pure. And Master combined these three ceremonies into one. What, why, who, when, where, how was a Buddha ceremony was conducted? Let us watch the video. The subtitle, English subtitle. Grateful to Buddha and all sentient beings. And Let's I'm very grateful for all moments of very grateful for every moment, and also for Buddha's blessings, and hope that everyone will be peaceful. Let's see this message. Yeah, this is the first Buddha ceremony in nursing department of Zhiji. There's also 1999 May 22nd at Hualien Hospital, and also Hualien. This one is 2000 at Hualien Jingshitang. And 2005 is at Taipei Hospital. We are 2006, it's the 40th anniversary of Zhiji. 2007, 41st anniversary at the Zhenzhong Lian Tang. 2009, 43rd anniversary. Yeah, 2010, the 44th anniversary is based on the Bodhi leaf. The formation is based on the Bodhi leaf. 2016, 50th anniversary as Zhongzhen Jing Lian Tang. 2018, there's also you can see that all the Dharma masters from gathered to perform. Everyone gather to pray to Buddha for the peace, for peaceful world. Because of a pandemic, we cannot hold a physical Buddha ceremony, so we were conducted online. You see that the ceremony was conducted at Hualien, as well as in Taiwan, in Taipei. In page 1963, that this gathering of all the Dharma masters, led by Dharma Master Yin Sun. Because of Yin Sun, Bandama, then there also various books. They are the stabilities in the world. It's all due to our collective karma. And there's a need that to purify people's heart. All religion must gather together to purify people's heart. So for a more peaceful world. Every Dharma master pray that all heart be purified, there's a peaceful world, that this pandemic can be overcome. We hope that people has less desires, also less in fighting among each other, that more hearts can be purified. Most important, we must overcome our habitual tendency. With Dharma in our heart, it allows us to understand that the karma, the working of the karma. So the Buddha ceremony is to cleanse our inner heart as well as to purify our mind. So we hope that more people will adopt vegetarian diet. Only Dharma can help us in overcoming all afflictions. We hope that we purify heart, all the pandemic can be over. And for Master's message to us is that this is a great lesson for all of us. There's a need to take care of all sentient beings. Do good deeds among the masses in order to have a peaceful world. Very important for us to adopt vegetarian diet so that there will be no further killing. And cut off all the bad karma that we an affinity with the animal and all sentient beings. Thank you so much. I pass it on to the next one. Very grateful to the sharing by sister.
你不需要很厉害才能开始一起来，你不需需要很厉害才能开始，但你需需要开始才会很厉害。明玲就是做一个最好的见证。我认识他的时候，我不会骗你，他根本是躲起来的，从棒棒三分钟到现在导读如此的精准重点，所以我们再次给明玲热烈的掌声。好，那。
You don't have to be specially talented in order to start something meaningful. This, what you have just experienced and your witness is a good testimony to how you can make a difference despite having little talent. So we really thank you, grateful for your sharing. Thank you for the English platform. We'd like to have all the people doing the channel to give quite further feedback. And we are very grateful for giving us a platform. So in order to give us this opportunity to understand more. And we thank you for the different people who have provided the feedback on the platform. Well, even though the program hasn't started, people are already commenting and anticipating that it's going to be a very meaningful program. Some people like a place to be beautiful, and others will make the place beautiful. So what would you like to be? So somebody is comparing us to the burning fire. So it's like us having a lot of energy, being able to spread the Dharma to everywhere. North America also left feedback for us. And Malaysia Chu Sun Li always say, he called me Mother Mei Yun. Why do you call me that? Are you my student? Or maybe I've taught too many people, I've got confused. Thank you very much. You know, sometimes when I teach so many students, then they come back one day and they call me Mei Yun, Mother. So I wonder. When I look at them, I say, oh, have I really given birth to so many children? But it's because it's a very nice way of to address someone dear to you. So since that time, I like being called that way, and my students like to call me that way too. Well, you say that Brother Ji's sharing was very meaningful, and all the ingredients he shared are so useful to our daily living. Well, our Lin Xinrong, who's next going to be the one sharing. Superintendent Lin Xinrong is so wonderful. We can actually write so many books in such a short time. Give me a test. He actually gave me a test. Do you know what's the meaning of this word? Well, I can't understand this word. So I really cannot give the correct answer. So he's such a wonderful superintendent. Well, this is the latest video that's emerged where he went forward to present ang paos to them, ang paos of blessing. Well, there's one of our brother who came back. So happened that when he came back, the time our superintendent was about to leave overseas. And can you imagine, he actually went to call him and wanted to meet up with him. Isn't it touching? You know, the whole team has really made, really settled down in heart and mind, because he's the one providing the surgery for him, taking care of him and curing him. Really, it's another very touching thing is, so sometime my mother will actually come on Wednesday to see me. This has got something to do with Singapore's brotherson. Yes, the brotherson was actually visiting master, and master noticed that brotherson was not doing so well. So he asked brotherson, "Are you okay?" And because of the timely intervention, brotherson was able to be treated and managed to recover from it. Isn't it a blessing? So sometimes when you just treat a patient and we don't keep them company, it's a different type of treatment. But our superintendent not only treat the patient, but actually follow through with the treatment and making sure that they recover well. Well, I know Singapore has got two brothers and who are famous, but I don't know which brothers and it is, but whatever it is, I hope Brotherson has recovered fully. He says that, you know what impresses me most? So all the while here, I noticed that all the responses are really going on, all ringing around me. So it's wonderful to see that the Kaohsiung Study Club is so successful. Well, this is something, another of his patients who has recovered. And the wife was saying, it's amazing, you know, when he had the injury from the front to the back, it's all full of injury. And there was a subdural hemorrhage. And because of that, we are wondering whether it's recovered. But, you know, I saw that, I read the superintendent's book, and before I reached one third of the book, I already started to go online to book the appointment to see Superintendent Ling. And today we can see so many people recover, and we can see so many patients being helped in a special way. And you really give back the dignity to the patients. And also, Malaysia, Malaysia reader also read about it, and actually, and he said, "Wow, I actually was given the book only 2 days ago, and I looked through it. There are 365 pages, and you know, guess what? It's so interesting. I read through the book in one night." So this book doctrines a lot of different cases and is a wonderful book, and it's very simplistic way of presenting the different therapies that benefited all different patients. So other than story, then we have also have different stories about Superintendent Lin. So he have got this book that that talk about how you should take care of your health when you are reaching age 40. So when we ask ourselves, what age do you start caring about yourself? Some people will say 50, some people will say 40. But actually, whether you reach 40 or not, you really must do preemptive action. It is important to realize that our health development is going through different phases. So when we are 40, it is actually the best time in our life. We are healthy, we are mentally alert. So we can keep this great level of health throughout. That will be wonderful. And this book has been coined by 16 experts. So this is a very important and special book. And here is another one who has been saved by Superintendent Lin. And we are really amazing to see how Superintendent has really put his heart to curing and taking care of his patients. And this is one of the brother Sun He. Sun He is one of the patients who have benefited from it, and today he has actually donated books to benefit everyone that is present here today. And you know, in the medical field, you need a lot of different devices. Then Sun He will actually invite a lot of entrepreneurs to together share the cost of providing this medical equipment. And this is another medical device that help in diagnosis and really magnify the images so that they have a clearer diagnostic tool to be available. Well, today again, we have another very special one. We have got the Jingshi herbal medication this herbal drink will benefit and boost your immunity. And this is a very special thing. So make sure you don't miss it. So we actually know about this stem cell therapy from years ago, but to be able to apply this technology to different diseases is truly innovative. And we go through the T cells therapy, and to be able to reduce the invasiveness of the cancer therapy. And we know that in this patient, for example, stroke patient, and we can actually do autologous stem cell transfusion to be able to inject into the area where the stroke have occurred. And very quickly, the blood vessels will join, and then the patient's activities and nerve responses are coming back again. Perhaps in the future, we can do such therapy in order to reconnect back people who are going through Alzheimer's disease. And hopefully all these sicknesses will be restored to health. And we will base our knowledge on the technological advances in the past 100 years. And even people with Parkinson's disease, on Taiwan is just one of those able to emerge from his Parkinson's deep-seated problem to be active again. We can use this innovative method in order to help this family. And this is our value in life, and this is to help bring back dignity to the patients. Oh, it's amazing how we can have this superintendent. Oh, we are so privileged to be able to see Superintendent Lin to be able to come here and join us. Well, Yuan-chang has really been personally helping us. As long as there's a need to do it, he would not say a second word to be able to come in and help us. We're going to have or even invited Li So Quan to help out. So everything is done for master so that the Dharma can be spread all over the world. And the Dean has spared no effort to do so. Yes. The Dean is truly a exemplary model for all of us to follow. We would like to support Lin Xinrong. He's really crossed the mountains and scaled the peaks. He really put his heart into all his work, and he do all his research, and he really bring away all the sufferings, and he really can bring people to walk and wake up and be able to be alert to the surroundings. We will really like to know that he will really be the one who will be able to bring all the wonderful tidings to the patient's family. And this is none other than our Ciji Lin Xinrong, Ciji volunteer Lin Xinrong. Well, this is another example of a patient. We'd like to welcome Superintendent Lin Xinrong. So, Superintendent, here in front there, you have Shijing Kui, brother Shijing Kui. Here, I pass you the mic. Maybe you would like to share very simply. He's so touched. He's a Kaohsiung entrepreneur. Well, it's time to actually go for rehab, but because he heard that Superintendent Lin is here, so he must be present here today. I'm really grateful to Superintendent Lin. He is able to cure from my husband's stroke. He was hospitalized for 37 days. We are so grateful because of Superintendent Lin, our family can still see our father. You just want to convey that it's so important to have a wonderful team of medical experts to be able to take care of my husband. I'd like to give you blessings in a song. May all the blessings be bestowed upon you. This is my uncle. Well, it's amazing. Uncle is his commission this year and in none other than Kaohsiung. And Tainan are the folks that are close to us. So we really thank you everyone for being able here to come here. We're grateful to Superintendent Lin for being able to come here despite his very, very busy schedule. You always ask people, 1 + 1 is equals to what? Some people don't care about him. And some people answer 2. Then you ask you, after you say yes, then 100 minus 3, what is that going to be? If they get it correct answer, then he will say, okay, you can go home now. Sometimes you say, why you keep asking me such silly question? Then superintendent will tell you, okay, then you can go home now. Thank you very much. Mei Yun, sister Mei Yun and mother Mei Yun. So because I like Sister Mei Yun, I call her Mommy, Mother. I come to Kaohsiung once a year. Amazing how capable Sister Mei Yun is in every aspect. Really grateful for Sister Mei Yun, Mommy Mei Yun. It's amazing how this book club is able to spread Master's Dharma to around the world. We have such great sharers who are able to bring out the effects and also the benefits of the Dharma to different people. And then the sister Wang also has shared very wonderfully just a moment ago. That's why my uncle, auntie all have come here to Kaohsiung. Kaohsiung provides job opportunities to many people, and many people from Tainan and Shijing come to settle in this place. In between, he's gone to USA, and then because of divine affinity, he's able to come in to Kaohsiung. And he's the first one to be commissioned, honorary commissioner. We are really able to see our family's first honorary commissioner. You know, in city, we always dress very properly and our attire is always well settled. And he feels that initially he had difficulty mixing, but now that he has entered and joined us, he's finding that it is so easy to be able to merge with everybody. He understands that Shiji is important to help people who are needy, those people who are poor, those people who need help in different areas. Even in as far as Pingyuan, even in a small land, we are able to connect with the Dharma of Master. So from very young, I've already started to have this affinity to be able to connect with Master's Dharma. So at first, I said, where would I have time? I was reassured that I don't have to do much. A lot of background work will be done for you. So when the 100-year anniversary, my alma mater was celebrating the 100 years and given me an honor to be part of it, and I'm thinking how to repay the rare honor given by my alma mater. What is unimaginable that, at the end of it, I still have to come out and sing. I was thinking, other than sharing my professional knowledge, you mean I still have to sing? So I was a little bit baffled. When I was going up stage, I asked Ling Lao Su to come along, and it's important. I invited him to go on stage and sing with me. That round, the amount of donation raised was actually quite sizable, and I'm very grateful for the opportunity to be able to help her. The title of my talk is being able to wake up and being able to walk. And this last phrase in the title is given by Fu Zong, Deputy Superintendent. Sometimes you wonder, such technique cannot be applied elsewhere. But when people come to Hualien, and people will see, actually there's a lot of different specialty departments here, neurology, stem cell department, and so on. But don't forget, this is all part of the team effort. It's exactly the same like the Ciji globally. We use the team effort, and this is the compassionate attitude of Ciji in order to benefit everyone. Because of time, I may do a little bit faster. So we would like to share who is the first one who actually scaled the mountains. It's none other than our master. Why is it that we have hospital? Because you say that there are many people who cannot afford the fee to stay in hospital. And because of his compassionate heart, Master has built a hospital. despite all difficulties face. So Superintendent Zeng told her, yes, it's possible, and it's to benefit both the sick and the poor. We just follow the direction led by Master. The important thing is our volunteers. Actually, our Hualien Ciji Hospital, the biggest difference between others is that we believe in the combined treatment of traditional Chinese and Western medicine. Lately, we talk about cell recovery, and there are so many people with spinal cord injury in Taiwan. Then with this method, we are then able to cure a lot of people with spinal cord injury. And we are able to combine the rehab portion with hyperbaric oxygen and combine medical and Chinese treatment. And we never give up, and we keep going. We would like to share a few cases that we have treated. And even the urology team, rehab team, the traditional Chinese medicine team, they're all coming in. And this is the integrated Chinese and Western medicine treatment with endogenous stem cells. We have actually done many different cases to increase the muscle strength of the people who are affected by different injuries, such as traffic accident. So you see, our patients are very busy, and our treatment success is based on the different rehab strategies of both the medical and the Chinese medicine. And we really see good progress by people. So to be able to wake up, able to walk, and to have abilities matching of vicious and dynamic is not easy. This is a lady who was working at the Ciji Foundation, Jingshi Abbot, he met with an accident, and he was sent to hospital. And he was already in very critical condition. Even breathing was very difficult. Then even there were fracture of the metacarpal bone. Then we have a combination of treatment, and this is where we can see Superintendent Lin visiting the patient. You can see Superintendent Lin visiting before Ms. Tian was discharged, and he was really going back to work. What our therapy is to combine treatment of medical and Chinese, Western and Chinese medicine. I can finish saying in 30 seconds, but I would like to share some cases with you. Sometimes there are different symptoms, you know, whether it's Parkinson's, whether it's hydrocephalus, whether it's cerebral small vessel disease. We're able to see the different images through the MRI and the throat scan.
受药啊，帕金森吃药啊，小血管吃药啊。那水脑症呢？啊，我们
So you can see the different disease pattern. Even in the lower right side, we're going to see the green patches. These are the rare lesions that we detected.
So you may change the change, huh? This is called neurological, huh? 都有哈啊，脑创伤也是啊，重要哈啊，接单哈，先生哈。
So those who are not able to wake up, they must wake up, and we will help them wake up.
他走路不稳啊，撞到的哈，出血，高一哈，也做了一些血块的处理。
So the traumatic brain injury is damage to the brain. Mr. Yang was one of those who had traumatic brain injury, and 2217, he had trauma into his brain, and going through the different therapies. He was able to be recovered to his current state. And it's not easy to go through that recovery process. And he continued to receive endogenous stem cells treatment. And you see, after the therapy, he's able to go back to recycling work. Here he can be seen dismantling the copper wire of the motor bobbin. So you see, like, tong 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 time. No? So he really happily doing his recycling. And he's able to be rehabilitated and do such fine work. You ask me to do it, I won't be able to do it. The Jing Si herbal drink is, we are thankful to master. Last time master always say, oh, whenever you go outside, make sure you must wash your hands. Maybe we can think of using our local herbs to wash our hands. And that was even before COVID-19. And it's already telling us that, well, it's possible to use our local Chinese medicine to be able to help and disinfect. So we went into a lot of research and about last year, middle of the year, and within the height of the COVID-19. And our research team has managed to experiment to block the virus spike protein from binding. So Master is encouraged us to do more research into this. And all the six PhD have stopped their work and concentrated on what Master have asked us to do. And maybe we just experiment and see whether we can do it. We're very grateful to Master. What you see round figure is the virus. So the surrounding it are actually the viral spike protein. So this TMPRSS2 is a protease. So with the protease, we are able to use that to severe that protease. So with this replication, the virus is able to spread through our body and will be affected, and it will multiply and go to all parts of our body. So this cell receptor ACE2 will be able to penetrate to our cells. So we can see that it can actually block the receptor, and it will also prevent the protease from doing its work. So in comparison, this may be even better than the Russian medicine Arpino. So we did an experiment. We realized that our Jingshi herbal drink is actually able to have a much greater effect. It's almost 4 times the effect of Arpino. So Hualien is very clean. Even to find a patient is difficult. Just so happened we have 2 patients who are able to came from Russia. One of them has come to our Hualien Shiji Hospital. So we tried different concentrations of the Jingshi herbal drink to test the effect. Using different concentrations of this Jingshi herbal drink, we were able to test out the effect of this. We're able to concentrate using some mixture of wine, some grape wine, and we are able to evaporate out the wine. Then after that, we fed them with this concentrated herbal drink, and within 1 week, already the effect is very obvious, and he's relieved of his viral attack. Whereas the other method, it took up to 45 days in order to have the effect. So on average, if you take the Jingshi herbal drink daily, it's non-toxic. So it's going to be a mild medicine to be able to boost up your immunity. There's no poison in it. Even if I talk a few days, a few nights, I won't be able to finish talking about it, you know, because the benefits are so widespread. 另外呢，还有什么特色？癌症的新希望啊，我们有一个A加B加C啊这样子的一个抗癌的方法啊。那尤其啊，有一个很独特的。So we are now able to produce more as we are doing the mass production of this Jingshi herbal drink. What else have we have? We now have new hope against cancer. We now have these oncolytic cells to treat tenacious cancer. These are Cici's new anti-cancer treatment module. COVID-19 will hurt us because he will deplete all our normal cells. But this oncolytic virus will actually kill away the tumor cells. So this is a very unique method in the whole of Taiwan. So using the oncolytic properties of this virus, we are able to perform cell therapy to kill the tumor cells. So they will replicate very rapidly when once in contact with the tumor cells. This 56-year-old with colorectal cancer, he already 4 years after his surgery, and already they spread to the liver and the lungs as well. So in medical terms, it's almost impossible to treat already. He already gone through all sorts of treatment, chemotherapy, surgery, so what else can we do? So we injected the oncolytic virus into the tumor cell. We realized that after we injected it, the CEA cancer index has gone down very quickly. So you can see the smile. Can you tell who is the patient? See the smile of the patient with terminal cancer is brighter than the attending physician. Hopefully, we can use this method on a widespread scale. So we can be able to massive destruction of the tumor cells. And this method is going to be so meaningful, and we'll be able to help more and more patients. Overseas, we do have such treatment, but every treatment can be more than 60,000 US dollar, whereas in Taiwan maybe it's 40,000 Taiwan dollar. So there's a huge difference in cost. We have different phases of the treatment. So there are now currently 9 phases of the treatment. So hopefully we develop a protocol. So the Ministry of Health has already approved this unmodified cell immunotherapy. So this is the first Shiji Hualien case approved by Ministry of Health. And this used the combined immunotherapy for treatment of colorectal cancer. So this bradycia with recurrence, relapse of glioblastoma multiforme. His wife is a commissioner, and we use this new method to treat him. And we can see that with treatment, he's able to walk again. So this is just a very amazing technology that we can use. So at first he had difficulty walking. Now after the surgery, he's able to walk again. So he used the methodology that he can even say, 100 minus 3, what is the answer? 1 plus 1 is equal to what? So he can use all this to test whether the patient can reply properly. And now we have a new stoma aid to be able to help clean the wounds. So all these different techniques are able to benefit different categories of patients. Of course, Hualien also has many different types of treatment. Of course, we won't have time to go cover all this. Now we're going to go to the next book, talking about talking about a new phase of treatment philosophy, and to remove the anxiety of patients. Compassion is so important. We can guard life, guard health, and guard love. We would like to combine the effort by everybody to be able to spread the great love to others. And we would like to share with you the Dharma, Master's Dharma, in our weekly meeting. Master has already given us that we must really seize every moment to be able to bring the great affinity to others. This grand education is very important for all of us. We'd like to invite Lin Yuanzhang to join us. Subrina is bringing this special ruler. You put this special ruler onto your forehead, you can measure your body temperature. Because Superintendent is here, we are able to have more Jingshi herbal drink product, and you can just take a time to browse through the different products and purchase them. When I first heard the news, I already feel very at ease. I must be postulating that basically this medicine must be traditional medicine. So when Master came to Kaohsiung, she talked about it, and today Superintendent Lin is able to tell us the statistics. So we must really safeguard health, and we must be able to list the 25 stories in the book. But you must not just bring back one book you must go to our Jingshi bookstore and get the copy that is signed by Superintendent Lin. So we can see from the different examples inside. So the different case history that described in the book give us a very detailed account of the different surgeries. So we can basically see the different details in the different cases. And because of the team effort, one of the cases, the mother say, "I don't know whether to cry or to laugh, because now my child is now able to be active and started to fight for toys." So it is something that's amazing. Master say he always goes forward, but he has not forgotten that he is just one member. He always brings his team along. He always talk about team effort, although he himself has moved forward. And can you imagine, he's really the benefactor for a lot of people. So we can see that indeed this superintendent is a special disciple of Master. So when we talk about the So we would like to invite you to echo the little special slogan that we have devised. We would like to organize a big group photo. So you say that Superintendent Lin always talk about special effect and share his Dharma even during his Monday meeting. So I'll pass over to the next person, Ganan.
Truly come to this live session.
Yes, let's all come together. You are great, you are great. So very great. It's a miracle. Truly a miracle. Yes, we are very grateful. So there are a lot of positive feedbacks about our Superintendent Lin. And these are the comments. We have comments from Cambodia. And he says that we here we can listen to many, many interesting stories.
非常简单，非常感恩。我们的 YK Chin 说 Thank you, sir, for the translation.
So Teacher Mei Yun is reading the comments left by our worldwide audience.
他就说他是第一次来加入这样的一个平台，但是他往后会常常上线。感恩这位好朋友，我刚才有看到。好，接下来呢，我们看到的是
One of the comments says that this is her first time to join this platform, and she will be joining in regularly.
台湾进行隔离中，很快会到主场来。其他家人呢？我们即将在十二月，我们即将在二月二十四号，你们不用来，书友不用来，但是我们即将跟我们的美国顺口溜团队，以及跨国跨区的英文口译团队，以及高雄团队跟跨区的文编美编进行云端相会。好，我们要联谊一下，这样子哈，来听听他们的声音。好
，Okay, and we will also have sharings from our U.S. team, translation team.These are the comments from last week's speakers regarding last week's speakers.
好，北京的周瑞新，今天高雄读书会寄予师兄妙智慧。
This is to our headmaster.
要活用，捐出房子先爱心，何必计较小马桶？
And this is from a sister from Beijing.
斋戒如数最重要，多结善缘入众生。持经文清五分钟，大爱之音妙之声，鼓励带动大陆人串起大爱之音。
So these are poems or rhymes that they created to describe their feelings and their appreciation of what the speakers have shared and their gratefulness to inspire them and to motivate them to do good.Now we have the rhymes from our US team. Let's read it together.
空傲静方汉左卓，原见江西九竹池，慈母心怀转逆子，承担陪伴多法喜，新年带来新希望，土地公婆退宿忙，一起来唱洗手歌，活络筋骨好健康，解密新冠刘怡君，科普绘本百冠王，怀念朋友信佳慧，慈大四季助抗疫，守护健康赖中福，解析胃食道逆流，一针二灸三用药，良好饮食早治疗呀，早治疗，一次爱的鼓励给我们所有顺口溜团队 ，Ready Go。
Yes, what a wonderful compilation of rhymes that describes the whole program of last Wednesday. You are so great. And now we can see that these are our volunteers from mainland China. And these are their sharings that they are very touched. And grateful to have the technology to be able to watch online. And all the way from mainland China, Shanxi, expressing their feelings of the positive energy that is being generated from the Kaohsiung Book Study.
连线完还会看回播，周周呢挑战自己来给我们写善效益，就每一个。
These are the brothers from China, and they are not just watching the live broadcast, but they are also they rewatch again the recorded sessions. And they praise the speakers, and they learn a lot about promoting vegetarian. And this is from a brother from Heilongjiang. And he has written about why all of us should adopt a vegetarian diet.And everyone feel very connected to our book study club. And now Now we see a lot of comments and articles from our audience. And all describing what they have learned and the inspiration that they have derived. Okay, so now we come. Yes. Now we come to this segment, Voices of Dharma. Okay, let us now invite Sister Shijing and Brother Wenqing. Hello everyone. We are both the hosts for the Great Love Voices. And we are here today again to share with everyone. We just need to use our finger to gently touch the screen and we'll be able to hear the sound of great love throughout the world. And every time in our Kaohsiung book study, we have a lot of positive impacts. And all the wholesome goodness that has been spread throughout the world. So now we see on this map that is marked in the red, that is the most northern end of China in Heilongjiang. And this is one of the volunteer. He has to take a train ride for over 2 days just to attend the training in Beijing. So that shows how far away is this place. And this is Brother Guan Jian. He is very diligent and he will go online to join the reading club and performs Ziji work diligently. Now we have Sister Zeng Lingjun from Beijing. She does recycling daily at the Eco Awareness Point. She regularly attends online book study and shares and influencing even more people to join and learn together. Now there is a Sister Huo Yawei from Anguo in Hebei. And she shows her gratefulness, respect, and love for the sanitation workers by sending great love packages in the cold winter. This brings warmth to the body as well as nourishing the mind with Jinsi aphorism. Yes, this is to show their gratefulness to the workers from the public hygiene bureau. Despite the cold winter, they have shown great vows and wisdom, overcoming difficulties during the pandemic to distribute care packs to the sanitation workers. And in the process, forming good affinities with them. The chief of the Environment Hygiene, Public Hygiene Bureau, even joined in as a volunteer on that day. He had also pledged to join to reduce the plastic campaign. So this shows that the spirit of great love is able to influence more people. And this is Sister Liu Junling in Xichang, Henan. And she led volunteers to care for the widowed and the poor families, helping them to tidy up their home. And she will also inspire volunteers to go online book clubs every week, learn master's teachings, learn the spirit of Ziji, and encourage young people to return home to practice filial piety and benevolence during the Double Nine Festival. You can see from the images, They have brought all the local people to show their filial piety to the parents. And our Chiji volunteers will encourage the village folks to be vegetarian and love our earth. And promoting vegetarianism to attract the new like-minded bodhisattva. And 8 years ago, the seeds of love were sown and to this brother, and today the seeds have sprouted under good conditions. Now let's go to Yunnan. This is Yang Ying. She is our first seed and commissioner from the Yunnan bi-ethnic group. She will go to the ethnic minority villages to promote environmental protection and even encourage them to use the lotus lamp instead of cutting down trees to burn the fires as part of the thousand years traditions, okay, to use fires. And using this method, they are able to protect the environment. And promoting vegetarianism to the ethnic minorities by collecting their signatures. And the sister Zhong Mu Hui from Kunshan also brought in the elderly to join the online reading club. And they are doing all the recycling activities. And our bodhisattvas in Northern California, USA, emerges in the local area. One of them is entrepreneur Lin Dunfang. She took part in community care for the homeless people and the nursing homes. During the pandemic, we still can be diligent by going online, forming good affinities using the Qingshi products. While reading and enjoying the products at the same time, we are also saving the earth and creating more good karma. So our Qingshi product had encouraged her to turn to vegetarianism, and she created a lot of delicious, tasty vegetarian meals to share with more people. And she made a vow to promote Qingshi products to even more people and to protect our earth. When one person is a vegetarian in a family, the whole family will love vegetarian. Delicious vegetarian food sharing and promotion, that is the power of being vegetarian. So when entrepreneur meets Qingshi, the result is recruitment of more donors and kind-hearted souls while growing our wisdom life. And our Kaohsiung Online Book Study, it's an international platform. And I'm grateful to be able to join the translation team. And this is a new experience for me. And the interpretation team will distribute the tasks among each other. Everyone is able to cover each other's, cooperate with each other, work together to accomplish the mission. And everyone works well together. And you can see that Teacher Mei Yun and our speakers will always come and give us encouragement at the end of each session. And because this is an online impromptu English interpretation, we will try to prepare well beforehand and learn and master the skills. And And even I would practice it beforehand and learn some professional skills. And in Ziji, we are always learning new things. Not just to translate the language, the words in the sentences, but rather to convey the message that the speaker is intending to share. And at my home, I have four computers and four mobile phones. They're all working in tandem for the English interpretation or for the broadcasting. So with a single finger, one can see the global love using technology. Every second will not be spared. Let us learn together actively and move our body to stay healthy and be focused in learning. We are grateful to everyone. 感恩. Let's give them our applause of love. You notice that the background is different because they have returned back to Taipei, their home in Taipei. Did you hear that they have four computers and four mobile phones working at the same time? And they are really busy when doing the broadcast and the interpretation. And that is when their heart, their mind would be very young because they're really focused and doing all this work. Let's give them another round of applause. Grateful. And he mentioned about the physical activities. And this is a very popular segment. Let's welcome our team to lead us in the physical exercise. This is a skit. Skit about the three sisters. And this lady is seeking consulting a doctor. And the doctor asks, where do you feel uncomfortable? And she said that, oh, my medication for high blood pressure has finished. And doctor says, okay, I will give you more medicine. And the patient says that, oh, doctor, I need more medicine for my gastrics and my liver. And the doctor says, no, I cannot just give you extra medicine. And she says that when I go to the market to buy vegetable, I always get extra vegetables. And how come you don't give me the additional medicine that I requested? So she is trying to request for the extra medication from the doctor. The doctor says that, I cannot help you in this area, but I could recommend you a very specialized doctor. He is our Hualien, Ziji Hualien Hospital Superintendent Lin. Oh, yes, he's very famous. I've heard of him. Oh, doctor, you are such a good person. And doctor, when you make lots of money, please donate to become our Ziji Honorary Board member.
And
why are
you laughing? Oh, don't you know?
This is my love exercise. The more I love, the healthier I will be. And the neighbor was asking, why is it that your three daughters till now are still not married? And she replied that there are a lot of suffering in this world. Let's not talk about small love. We should be spreading great love among more people. Oh, did you know that in my house we have 5 levels, 5-story house, and I live at the 4th level, and I will go to the 5th floor to wash the floor, wash the clothes. And she says that, wow, if you want to leave, we should move more. We need to move our body to be more healthy, and we should be a vegetarian. And the neighbor says that, oh, I have become a vegetarian and I will become slimmer. And the neighbor says that she's very happy because her sons give her NT dollar $10,000 a month. And the other lady says that, oh, my daughter give me
$1,000 a day. And
every time when I tell my daughter that my eyes are blurry and I couldn't see well, my daughter will take out the dollar note, the $1,000 note, and my eyes will then, well, eyes will open wide and I'll be able to see clearly. So we should be doing more good deeds by giving and donating to help the needy. And I'm very filial to my parents and my grandparents. And our master says that children who are filial to parents, they are the most blessed. So we
should
be grateful to our parents and we'll be most blessed.
请面带微笑哦.
Okay, let's all stand up and do our hand washing exercise.
One, two, three.
一二三四五.
Are you ready? One, two, three. 这个动作八次.
洗手，
换边，手背，换边，手心，食指交错，
来回搓。
我 one， 我 two， 我 one two three， one， 我 two， 我 one two three， 指尖，换边，虎口。我们要吸水哦，哇 S， 哇，小心风啊，小心风。
还有一个音乐哦，我们可以一起来。哇，有吗？啊，很好，来，手伸起来，我们探长。哦，面带微笑哦。
Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence.
这就是因为爱哦。下一个动作，超慢跑，一样，面带微笑，迎向阳光。 哇，阿嬷叮当起来，别卖吼！哇，我看大家哦，笑眯眯哦。哇，动物是不是很可爱啊？好，来，手，好，往前推。
10,000 people dreaming more，拉开我们的心包机。哇，很有呼吸，对不对？
好，双手，好，再来，金鸡独立，哇，是姐一直抓，对不对？没紧张，慢慢来吧。哇，你看，长官嘛在抓，好，我们慢慢放。
大家有没有很平安？平安健康的人给自己掌声。好，我们的活络筋骨是非常让大家怎么样欢喜的一个单元哈，就是三小时我们中间起来活络。那2021年的时候，我们有四组哦，从2020年的两组，然后四组，其中如果遇到第五周，大家请说第五周的时候谁会出来带动我们的长照阿公阿嬷？ 他们好，所以我们会第五周的时候就会他们好。这边云端来自美国北加州的林敦芳也一起邀约美国长大的女儿一起来收看，看到姚师姐介绍介师兄在直播线，他说就像看到本人一样。哎，你女儿是听英文的还是中文啊？敦芳好。那我们的呼和浩特张培元师姐就内蒙的说，季宇师兄，妙宇妙田，哎，这还在季宇师兄哦。
太厉害了，你还在微博。Okay, now we have more comments from our worldwide audience. And this is from Inner Mongolia. Describing their feelings and their feedbacks on what they have heard last week.
好的，那我们往下走，我们的单元待会我再跟大家。 回顾这一些在线上给我们回应的家人，
okay, let's move on to the next segment.
虽然我没办法每个人都用到，但是我们真的是非常感恩您给我们这样的直接给我们这样的一个祝福力量是非常重要的。
And we are grateful that all of you have put in your positive comments and encouragement.
哦，他也太快了哈，嗨，吓死我了哈。 非常感恩我们的
okay, now,
我们的佩玉师姐。那佩玉师姐大家其实很熟，因为她角色扮演太多。那大家可以看到这样的一个回顾带，那一边其实呢是有菜头梗的滋味，
okay,
有没有？这一档
好戏前面。Now we can see our sister Peiyu。
在这个当下呢，其实她是来分享一下，而且我记得是临时穿插的，所以他并没有用到三十分钟。可是即便短短的时间，他还是愿意前来，所以我们可以看到呢，就是在这一段时间，我们也非常感恩我们的文书团、影音团队，疫情之后我们改为一个月做一次，那在这个当下里面，我们可以看到我们即兴登场的样昂扬，就是在这个来谈的金色的日常。那这个对我们来讲，因为网页版
Okay, so now we will have our next speaker. So she is the
She's
part of the documentation team that created the books and the media. And she have came to our book study previously, and she's not new to us. And previously, there was this blessings, prayers, for our families, our medical team members, and as well as the whole world. This is a prayer blessing session for everyone to write their blessings on the card. So she was our Dai TV host, and now she's a producer. And she has created many good programs.
And
Sister Peiyu, she has created a lot of programs. That includes one that recollect back the history of Ciji and the early commissioners that had contributed in the early days. Because the earlier histories are mainly oral histories. There were no written records or media to capture the history. So now we are capturing back all this history by interviewing our senior volunteers as well as our abbot masters.
So let's
give a round of applause to our first speaker. And she had created a series of programs about our e-books. And she was a host for our New Year programs as well. And she could host, she could be the producer, and she's multi-talented. And she could create programs that is most needed by us at this present time.
Okay, using the various method to present this, we are very grateful to these sisters. She always gives us the latest. Let us give her warm applause and welcome her. Let's hear her sharing. Dearest Master, about Masters, and of course, Superintendent Ling, and online live audience, families. Good day, everyone. Very grateful and very happy to be here. Since when I've come here, I can't really remember. This online is really 8 years old. I came here since it was 3 years old, so I'm truly happy. Let's seize the moment and very speedily. Some people will say, hey, Sister Peiyu, you have already hosted and so many sessions, and how many are the most insightful? I'll share about three because of the time constraint. Maybe let me share between me and master the conversation between both of us are mostly quite comical. Let me introduce. Since this year, 2021, our program, Dharma Voices, we have restructured some of the programs. You could see that, of course, daily wisdom at dawn, of course, the eminent Dharma Master, and of course, the insights of these eminent Dharma Masters, and the Dharma Voices that I program myself, produce, and online as well, posted. And most important, I must remember each moment, must do my basic responsibility and a high expectation on self. This picture, you could see that this during the early years, 1997, that point of time. You could see that. Can you find me? It's okay if you can't find me. You can see Xiao Chen, Brother Xiao Chen. He has left us on top. The finger that pointed to the person who is that in the she's also a family. Now she's a very famous MC Li Zhen Zhen. Next to the person, someone's familiar, she came to share. Who is she? Chen Zhi An. Another side, you could see. Okay, the finger has pointing the person, Jian Kai. Okay, these are the early years family. 1997, that point of time, we don't really have the present name. That point of time, what we were wearing, we don't have uniform. So our uniform were the blue-white uniform. Let us put across this picture. 20th anniversary. We play this as remembering the past, the senior volunteers. Among the group, I'm considered the newest, the latest addition. You could see from here their footprints, what they have done. Most of them, they are still doing what they have done in the past. This one, of course, very important with Master. That point of time at Taipei, 6th floor. Our office there at Taipei, 6th floor. The first story between me and Master in this, it took place at this place, at the picture shown just now. That day, actually, I just joined Ziji, not really long joining Ziji, because I just set up, you know, just when it's just set up, it was quite not stable. That time afternoon, some of the volunteers said, hey, this evening, let us go to meet Master, because we heard that Masters from Da'ai doesn't look so happy. Let us chit-chat with Master. I was thinking, why not? Yes, let's go. But I wasn't aware that morning. How would I know that night time I would meet Master? I never expected. So I was wearing my skirt. So of course you have seen that place, right? Coincidentally, that time, actually not really very big, just like a quarter of what we're having this place. So all of us were sitting surrounding Master. And I was sitting just opposite in the middle, and I was wearing my dress. You can imagine that. So we were sitting on the floor. I was thinking, okay, so my both legs put together, cross. I was a very dignified way of sitting down. 1 minute, 2, 3. And I was thinking, oh dear, so painful legs. I really have to stretch my legs out. So I slowly stretch my leg. So I tried to bear it, but it was not easy. So after, I need to change my position again. So I keep changing my position from one moment to another. So I keep telling myself, okay, it's time, you should stop. Don't keep moving your legs. So I started to rub my leg. Oh dear, it's numb already. I can't feel anything. Another sister, she found me and asked me to, she asked me to be seated at the chair. I was so happy. I wanted to stand up, but I can't stand up because my legs were numb. So Master, she was in front of me, right? I'm not sure whether have you seen Master as smiling? She's truly dignified. Of course, because of my skirt was so short. So the most important mission is to make Master happy. So Master was so happy. Actually, it was not really very short. It's just like above 1-2 inch above the knee. But everyone knows that in Ziji, the skirt must be below the knee, covering the knee. So since then, I've never worn that short skirt. So that part of time when I stood up, I couldn't move right. Everyone was smiling and laughing. Mother smiled too. Master said, so long you are at ease and peace. A lot of people, when they see Ziji, they say, Ziji has so many rules and regulations. There's certain ways of sitting, standing. I better don't join Ziji. Let me share with everyone. Actually, all these principles and regulations are really not that many. So long you come and join us, you feel at ease. Master said, just be at ease and peace. Very important. So that reminded me, don't be troubled by all these regulations. Next story. Okay, this picture. So adorable, right? Do you know the person next to me? That point of time when was there, I didn't know who he was. 2013, Chicago. Those families are 20 years. I went there to interview the behind. Of course, Brother Paulus, two daughters, and Brother Christopher at the side. So later, then only I found out that I was with a Brother Christopher and this young boy. I remember this young boy. He's truly adorable, right? That point of time, I used this microphone to talk to him. His hands is the hand. The legs also function as the hands. He was the victim of Agent Orange. He's truly adorable. Just the head, the legs also function as the hands. It decided my next mission for my next life that has very something to do with him. And this person is Dharma. We look at the boy in red shirt. So long you look at the bone marrow, you will see him. He's Kyle. That he's from New Jersey. 2011, 16 hours trip. If the parents come to Taiwan to meet the person who donated the bone marrow, the listening chin, the lady who carried this boy. That point, I know this of this boy, Cal. So in the train station, because that part of time during Mother's Day, we wanted to take the train from Taipei to Hualien. So during the trip, I interviewed the mother. The mother said, they are vegetarian. I was thinking, U.S. people come to from New Jersey and they are vegetarian. I thought they are not vegetarian. I thought U.S. people, normally they are not vegetarian and this happens to be vegetarian. I find it weird. So I asked again. So the cow, he's 5 years old. He used the hand to, he said, don't want to eat them. I don't want to eat them because we love animals. We don't eat the animals. That point of time, that second, I thought to myself, a 5 years old boy, because his compassion of animals, he don't eat meat. Can't I do the same? So since 2011, Mother's Day, after interviewing him, I have stopped eating meat. I made the same vow like him to be vegetarian. So since then, I truly embrace that. So actually, in fact, before that, I don't really eat a lot of meat. But of course, with that, he has inspired me and I could purify my mouth and I eat vegetarians. That point of time, 2011, Ziji have not really pushed or promoted vegetarianism. So when Master came, they asked me to talk to Master. So I shared this story. And Master said, when you are next to me, I can't talk to you, promoted to you on this, but a 5 years old boy could do that to you. And I couldn't, I was speechless, not really, I purposely, such is the affinity. So, task arising from the causes and conditions, task also ceases with the cause and conditions. Why do we often hear a lot of teaching, but we can't get in? I'm not too sure. So, but because of this boy, I embraced vegetarianism. I started to eat vegetarian food. Okay, this is very adorable. Why do I write 3 years old? Actually, he's 5 years old. Maybe I'm short of some wisdom. Okay, sorry, actually, I'm the one who wrote this paper. He's 5 years old. He was 5 years. So he wanted to meet a bone donor. 2015, later, the 5 years old boy, he has grown up so big. 2011, today, how old is he? 24 years old. They are brothers and sisters, so meet him and seek him to be a volunteer. Already a few years. So the latest small story between me and Master, me as a host. This is my style when I host for Master's session. Everyone will be a bit tense, but for me, then for me, hosting is something natural. So for Guan Chu session, I was asked to do this Taipei hospital session. So for me, it's okay. So I came here. So I wear the normal the shirt, the costume that you could see. 2011, that point of time, sister told me that at Guan Chu, there's a session, there's something happened with the host. Can you go and help step in as the host? So I was thinking, okay, Francisco, I have an immediate question. I asked, that session, is it for commissioning? Everyone will be wearing cheong sam chipa, but the part that I don't have the shirt. Can I wear the ta uniform? She said it's okay because it's so last minute crucial. You just go and host. I was thinking if you think that it's okay, then I'll just do that. So after the song of the one heart, one mind, so the next session for us to introduce Master to pass on the text to the commissioners. Then we say, okay, welcome Master. Okay, in front of us, as Master walk up, he will pass the host. Master stopped and was so close up. Master, look at me, bending the head slightly around 3 seconds. And Master said before, 1 second is one lifetime. It passed 3 seconds and was thinking, what happened? The second. And I was thinking, how could I let the person bending? So the third second, I bend my head down and Master walk over. And after the session, I asked Sister Zhiyang, what happened? The 3 seconds, it was like forever. She said, nothing. I look at you, you're very dignified. I mean, very respectful. You bow and Master. But the first 2 seconds, no one look at. I was so close to Master and I was looking eye to eye at Master. And I was thinking, what has happened? So that time, so after that, Master went on to other commissioning trips. So I follow Master, and very weirdly, during the big session, Master didn't say. But during one of the smaller sessions, Master said, "Nowadays people, they are really willing to help, but they're not willing to uphold responsibilities." So for me, I was thinking, I follow Masters from all the sessions. And during the smaller session, I was thinking as if the old Master was talking to me. And I asked myself, what has happened? So I reflected, maybe I started to not only willing to accommodate, but I also willing to uphold my responsibility. In the past, because in the past, I was never a commissioner. I never thought that I need to do this. So later that it dawned on me, yes, I need to seek certification. Because in the past, it was easier to seek certification. Now you have to undergo the training from GNC Peixin before commissioner. But then I have not yet, I have not seek refuge under master. So because of that, it suddenly dawned to me that it's time for me to seek refuge from master. Why do I have to seek commissioner? So I was thinking, now you, during the encounter, because when you are certified seeking the refuge, then you have the strength to move on. So this is the meaning of Chen Dan, uphold responsibility, being a disciple of master. So finally, I'm a disciple of master. So because of people were thinking that, a lot of people, they didn't know that I have not yet sought refuge from master. So okay, later you can hear stories of Sister Mei Yun and Master. This is so adorable. Let us hear this part. There was a time a sister told me, I heard, because some people, they are at this sleeping mode, keep sleeping, and Master saw them. That point of time, Master didn't ask people to wake me up, but asked the person next to me, please take the program sheet and pass it to me to have a look. Master didn't even ask the person to wake me up. And Master looked at the program. Master said, you're so tired. No wonder until this hyper person also cannot wake up, because the person is over, have done so much. So after I've heard that, actually normal person do feel unbearable, feel so, why Master needs, she has to do that. But for me, I just laugh it off. At school, children normally request the teacher, because I'm Sister Mei Yun as a teacher, needs to put in more effort. When I heard Master say I'm a hyper child, at that point of time, I make vow, I want to be a hyper child in Ciji, because whatever Master wants to do, I hope to quickly follow closely and put it into action. Actually, Master accidentally saw me falling asleep. It was something which was very embarrassing, but reflecting, that is truly a blessing to me. So when whatever Master wishes to do, I hope I to be a hyper child and help Master quickly put into action. Look at this hyper child. She's truly amazing, superb. Not only in Taiwan, she's already a hyper person for the global scene. Our role model hyper person. Thank you, Sister Mei Yun, Teacher Mei Yun. At Kaohsiung last year, I already interviewed a few people. It will be aired one by one. The next, maybe later, Brother Fang, Master Ha Fang, the great, very famous for making cake, Yi Shifu. Maybe you look at this piece. This is her, no? Before Master, about Master, attended, joined a boat 20 years old. Master from Taipei asked a Wei Yuan, a commissioner, to buy a Western suit, pass it to me to return home. Master, which actually intention is for my family, for my family to be assured, comforted that I'm doing well. Because I was only 20 years, I was at Hualien. So Master, because I wanted to return home, so Master asked someone to help me buy the Western costume. So the family will look at me with the Western costume. They feel comforted that I'm well taken care of. And us, it's like smoky all over the place and one there. I must be nearing there. there's already a one person there. Master will be relieved and ask her to get someone volunteer to help to make a pair of clocks so she could be elevated a bit. Else, she will be too short and dangerous. So such is the caring thought of Master. Master couldn't see the person. It's all covered by the smoke. But later, when Master discovered, Master is very caring. As all these years, as I follow Master, I noticed that Master really cares for everyone. Not only your safety, but including your wisdom life. Master always will observe and care. From what we have seen, that is about Master Yi, you could understand, right? Because the smoke from cooking the big wok. So for instrument, she's truly very small size, like that, very short, I mean, the type. And of course, another sifu, her sifu is very tall. U.S., when both these master together, one is very tall and another one very, they're adorable. Both of them are truly adorable. All the things share about masters, the reason I wanted to do all this interview because for everyone to know the about master, we know, we have seen them, we just call them sifu, but we are not sure their name. This is An Shifu, An Rong Shifu, and Yang Shifu. The first five are our most senior about masters. The next, they are the seven brothers, the 10th, Ruf Shifu, the 11th, An Shifu. Next, we are close, Xuan Shifu, about master, Xuan. Next is Yi Shifu, the master. We could see the Nian Shifu, right side, Ding Shifu, the master Ding. They are the top, the senior 20 about masters. You can recognize them. For example, like, can you see this? This, okay, like Ying Shifu and this Man Shifu. Both of them, they are from the same class because their Buddhist name has Lei from the same batch. And Han. About Master Han. About Master Qing Shifu. Both of them, they have R. So they are from the same batch. Jian, that was a Jian. And Su Shifu, they have the cover. So they are from the same batch. This is for us to recognize this year, they are team monastic. There are two types. One is the office one, another type, more administrative by nature. Another one is the one who needs to go out to the field, go outside and cleaning the dorm, everything is under the one with actions cleaning. Have you eaten at Jingshi? So after we have eaten, we will clean our own bowls, right? Do you notice a group of boat monastics washing dishes? Actually, these are from the office monastics. They will use the time after eating the meals, they will use the time to wash the dishes. So it's from the angle we are looking at this to the monastic masters. When they go down to eat, they'll bring their own bowl. If you forget, what will happen? The sifu, okay, for us, right? If we forget, the sifu will pass it to us. But to Abba Master, it's called siwan. It's a pastor. For them, public one is the one serving the dish with the dishes. But with the rice, the bowl for the rice is personal bowl. Then maybe we will think that, hey, I thought it's the same, the rice bowl, isn't it the public bowl? But actually it's different for the monastic. Monastic sifu, they have a special line to wash all these public dishes, the plates or actually utensils. Actually, a lot of things, there's no right or wrong, but there's a certain reason for that. I always confused a bit on this public and private. I get confused. I was thinking, isn't it? I'm using it. I'm using from the public, but what is it known as a private bowl? Actually, there's no right or wrong. It's just that, I mean, there's a certain regulations perspective on this. So often at times, a lot of disagreement, I mean, different understanding, misunderstanding happens because of this. So we have to come up and look at it as a broader picture. Recently, a lot of blooming lotus flowers, right? Master is very comforted. So long, everyone is learning the Dharma and they have increased in the wisdom life. Master is truly very happy and comforted. So this year, there's one program on this. I've interviewed the Ziji volunteers. Those maybe I left out interviewing them in the past. Maybe they have been Ziji for more than 10 years. Please contact these people and call this number. These are the role model. Please contact me. I will go and do interview with them. Everyone, please help me. Help me a bit, okay? Everyone, you are all the extension of me. You're helping me to find all these people. Okay, so that I could interview them. We have this blooming lotus. Of course, later we will. Now we're compiling stories. We could compile more and more stories and publicize it. To online, we have our brothers and sisters from around the world. The one that we're seeing, these are all these the QR code. We could use it. If in China, please join the with. If you're Taiwan, you can join LINE. WeChat for China. This is daily. We'll pass it to everyone. This chat group from Malaysia, US brothers and sisters. Please, US and Malaysia brothers and sisters, don't flash this because it's only for other countries. But if you wish to receive the Dharma Voices, you can please flash this one, the F-book, the Facebook. Use Facebook. Yeah. Most important, take out your handphone and please flash the QR code. Very importantly, when you flash this, the QR code, the middle, I believe, okay, you can do it at home. After you have flashed that, you arrive at this. Just now, we have seen the Dharma Master Yi. So when you are here, this is the most important. Can you see all this? There are different chat group, right? There are different platform, LINE, Facebook, WeChat, WhatsApp. You can share a Telegram and you can, after you have read this and below are the explanation summary, please extend it, promote it, pass it to people, your friends. It will appear at the right side of the sample and find the people you wish to share. After that, please press share. It can go out. Can you do that? Please be the spreader of Dharma and have a share. And the book study, the book that we're using is Lotus Sutra, 30th January. Now we are publishing this Wisdom at Dawn, Lotus Sutra. Parable. Okay, the chapter of Burning Fire. And the next one, the beggar one. Of course, we will link up resonating all the principles to the present happening, the events. May I just remind everyone, Master said, to hear, to listen to the Dharma, and to understand, listen, contemplate. We have earlier heard that to listen to the Dharma, listen, contemplate, and practice it, spread it. May I ask, normally, Master always talk about the small star. How do you share this small star? Do you know where is this little star of Ziji? How big is the star? And for it to circulate the sun, 5 years, 7 months, the distance, all this, the position. I not only know about the Dharma, I must immerse in it, then only I can spread it. So it's not only listening, you must understand clearly the Dharma that Master is sharing. I'm also learning, looking hard on this. Let us together with global family, we walk along and then we improve along the way. Very grateful. Okay, this is the rate of the program, and okay, our translator will have a great challenge to translate, but at the same time, we are very excited, including all the feedback from the listeners. Everyone, they feel the relationship with the masters. Everyone have their own relationship, master. Very grateful to everyone. Not only we are able to accommodate, able also to uphold the responsibilities. And everyone affinity with master is different. And imagine that the affinity with master, that is very important, and must keep close to that. I'm very grateful. Truly, this 5 years old boy is a great benefactor. Don't underestimate this small little boy. Small little boy also can a great benefactor. Sister Effie, who shared this, she's talking about the relationship, the affinity between Sister Peiyu and Master and the vegetarian is because of this, inspired by this 5 years old boy. So let us a round of applause to Sister Peiyu. Okay. So next translator.
Master, volunteers from all around the world, good afternoon. I am from medical Tima medical team, Dr. Hong Hong Tian. Seeing today, doctor will be sharing about the new concept of filial piety from a medical point of view. What is the definition of filial piety? Filial piety is the first of all good deeds. We have to obey our parents, take care of our parents. The most important thing is our parents must must take care of the basic things such as food, clothing, housing, and transportation. This is the basic obligation of children to their parents. Filial piety means to obey the parents' words and act according to their parents' wishes and follow the parents' standard in everything. We as a children, maybe we are providing excessive care of the elder one and have done everything for our parents, hire helper and replace, that will cause our parents not able to move much because everything is done by the helper. So all this because of this, for safety reason. However, when we avoid excessive activities, this will cause loss of muscle masses that causes sarcopenia and accelerates aging and disability. This is the misinterpretation of filial piety. So for older people, they may think that I'll just maintain my original knowledge and doesn't want to learn any new things and trouble other people. So for parents, we thought that we just obey and this have caused our parents to lose touch with the new information. When they do not want to seek for new knowledge and not motivated, they do not motivated to do new tasks. The French biologist Lamarck theory of use and disuse. If we did not use the muscle in our body, it will lose its muscles, it will degenerate, and it become the muscle will be degenerated, and the brain will also degenerated. So we have to have have daily training for our parents to maintain brain vitality and physical strength. So if we can move, we do it so that this will increase our physical strength and enhance and maintain our body muscles. So let us watch this exercise by our teacher. If we are able to move, he's very blessed, and we should do more exercise, physical movement. Okay, twist and breath, take deep breathing and push to the left and under control. Every movement are under control. Okay, push and come back. If you are not able to stabilize, you can hold on the wall. With this exercise, okay, the master's interpretation of true meaning of filial piety. When we drink water to think of the source of the water, our life comes from nurturing of parents. Let our parents to maintain a healthy body and mind. Filial piety is to let our parents be happy and at ease, keep our parents to have healthy and mental good memory, to take care of parents' physical and mental health so that they have strong physical body. Let our parents to take care of their daily life. Let our parents to do housework, participate in house chores. Let our parents to join in community activities in the society to achieve the revitalizing aging. Successful aging is to avoid critical illness and loss of memory, maintain the physical and mental functionality, join the community activity in the society. Japanese writer Kishimi Ichiro wrote, "The best filial piety is not being filial, that is, don't do everything well for your parents. Leave some harmless things or tasks for your parents to do so that they will not degenerate. Have a good relationship with parents. Do not argue with them. Change the way of interaction with parents. If we have some unhappy moments with them in their early days, change our perspective. When our parents are old, they don't remember us, treat that day as your first meeting so that your parents will know you again. Let our parents do whatever task they are able to do on her own. If caring for your parents, you feel tired, ask for support from others. New concept of filial piety. As long as the tasks are not dangerous, can be done by parents and are they able to move, try to let the parents to do it themselves. As long as the parents can walk, try to let them walk by himself and train his balancing in standing. Let the parents to stimulate the brain function and let our parents to participate in community activities, achieving the purpose of revitalizing aging. So for elders, if your children ask you to do things, do not be grateful to them because they are to protect our health. Thank you for Tainan volunteers for attending live in this Kaohsiung online study. Thank you very much. Then we have Yang Dingyan Yeye and Ama, who are also here at this site. Neimong, they are grateful that the volunteers are benefiting many peoples, and to have a healthy body, that is the most important things in our life. And grateful for all the wonderful sharing. Brother Peiyu also says that time flies, as just now you can see the photo of her two children with Brother Christopher. Now they are already teenagers. And this book from doctors, you can buy these books from the Jinse Book and Cafe and share with others so that everybody can maintain their health. And now we have Jinse products. These are new flower teas. 金丝小月红茶。New Year is coming. You can choose to buy the products as a Chinese New Year gift. And we have this vegan cooking powder, vegan ginger flavor, and we have this soya beans powder. In my house, we drink this every day, mixed with black sesame powder. Every day, we love the products from Jingshi. Whatever we face every day are good affinities. If we are blessed, we must be diligent and stick fast to do Ciji work. Yeah. Next week, we have online session with our brother Yu Chen. And we have next week, we have Mr. Chai Ping-kun, Vice Mayor of City of Taipei, where every place that he went, the place will be beautiful with spread the seeds of love. And we have this recall the memory relationship between master and disciples. At that time, no community center set up at Taipei. Sister Jing Ying will host master at her house, and it is a good place to discuss Ciji matters. Want to know what master discussed about on Ciji? Please watch this session. In March, we have Chi Mami, another sister will be sharing as well. Yeah, every Wednesday, please join this Kaohsiung book study. I will have many wonderful, inspiring sharings from our volunteers. Yeah, let us pay homage to Triple Gems, first bow, second bow, and third bow. Let's wave our hand. Let's all the sharers, please come with me. We will go to the interpretation, the translation group.